Hello friends, good to see you again on another edition of Footprints. This morning I'm going to be sharing with you what I call What Kills the Anointing, which is a follow-up on my earlier video where I shared about how to walk in the anointing. Okay, so yeah, if you have not seen that video, you'll have to visit our YouTube channel to watch the video because this is a follow-up to that video. The first thing that kills anointing is pride. When anointing comes, the anointed may now begin to think highly of himself. When the anointing comes, the anointed may actually begin to think that he is invaluable. When the anointing comes, the anointed may begin to think that he is no longer flesh and blood. James chapter 4 and verse 6 says, God resists the proud and gives grace to the humble. The book of Proverbs 16 and verse 18 says, pride goes before destruction. An haughty spirit goes before a fall. Okay? I'm beginning to see that your head is swelling because of the anointing of God upon your life. And if you continue like that, you are likely to crash out of anointing. The book of 2 Chronicles chapter 26 and verse 16 gave us a gory story of Uzziah the king of Israel, who went to the temple to carry out an authorized offering that a priest should do. Even when he was confronted, he was not remorseful. Leprosy broke up on his forehead and he was consumed with that leprosy till the rest of his reign. I don't know the weakness that the people of God is confronting you with. And I see that pride is already overshadowing you and you are not repenting of that weakness. Friends, you are likely to go down under the weight of the anointing. The second thing is lack of accountability. Every anointed man needs somebody to watch his back for him. Every anointed man needs to be located in a godly relationship of people that we oversee him so that he can last in that anointing. Okay? Accountability is a safety line for every anointed man. I cannot say this to you. Anointing does not remove over any man the responsibility of accountability. So no matter how gifted you are, no matter how anointed you are, God still wants you to stay in accountability relationship. That you are gifted does not mean that you cannot make mistakes. That you are gifted does not mean that you don't need to have anybody to watch over you. Okay? Proverbs 27:17 says, iron sharpens iron. A friend will help his friend to stand. Judges 14:3. Samson rejected the accountability of his parents when he confronted them to marry a Philistine woman from Timnah for him. Even a sharp rebuke from his father was rejected by Samson. From that point, Samson started going down. Number three, things that kill the anointing over a man is presumption. When the anointing comes upon a man, he might begin to lower his guard. That man might begin to take for granted several disciplines that help him to the point that he already gotten to now. He might begin to lower his consecration, his prayer life, his fasting. Every spiritual discipline that brought him to that point might begin to be toned down. And he might begin to take the anointing for granted. The way Samson took it for granted. In Judges 16:20, Samson said, I will arise and shake myself as well. But he does not know that the presence of God has left him. 1 Samuel 3:18, Eli said to Samuel, he's God, let him do what he likes. The result of that statement was terrible in the lineage of Eli. He lost his two sons in a day. He died too because he took the anointing over his life for granted. Number four is burnout. When you are involved in ministry under the anointing for a long time, you are not refilling your strength, you are not resting, spiritual and physical fatigue is likely to drain you. And when that happens, you become susceptible to attack. That happens to Elijah in 1 Kings chapter 19. After the contest on Mount Carmel with the prophets of Baal, Jezebel sent word to him the second day, and because of the tiredness, Elijah took to his heels. Actually, that's what happened. When a man burn out, they bow out. The last and the final thing that kills the anointing of a man is sin. When the anointed begin to meddle with sin, when the anointed begin to compromise in sin, they soon go down under the weight of the anointing. The statistic of men who are fading out, who are falling out of the anointing, is growing. I pray that you are not going to be part of that statistics. People who taught you that whatever you do does not affect your spiritual life, it does not affect your anointing, has deceived you. Judas has the unique opportunity of Jesus laying hands on him. He casted the devil, he healed the sick, he probably raised the dead, but he crashed out of apostolic ministry because of greed. Gehazi left parted with leprosy instead of the anointing of Elisha. Go and ask David, a man that was called a man after God's heart, in the aftermath of his affair with Bathsheba, sword never departed from the house of David. I'd like to challenge you that as you go, watch out for these red lines. If you really desire to last in the anointing, I pray for you as I go, pay attention to these red lines. God will keep you, God will preserve you. I pray for you that you will not become an history, you will not become a shadow of yourself in God. I pray that the curse of Ichabod will not come to rest upon your life. Thank you. God bless you. I'm sure you have been blessed by this video. And if it has blessed you, it's definitely going to bless other people. So I love you to share it from whatever platform you are viewing it from. Facebook, WhatsApp, or YouTube. I love you to go to our YouTube channel and subscribe to our YouTube channel, OBM TV channel, and click the notification button. As you do this, God bless you. Thank you.